welcome back to my channel, you guys. Oh my goodness, I'm super excited because today I'm going to be teaching you all a few digital art tips of how to improve your digital artwork, you guys. I'm really excited, and I will be sharing you all my process of my cute Pika babe, okay? Or Pikaboo, as I call her, because I just think that's so cute, because you get it? Pikachu, Pikaboo, that's just so cute to me. But yeah, you guys, I definitely love digital artwork. As you've noticed, I've been doing it a lot more. I use Procreate, and I use it with my iPad Pro 12.9 inch, and it is just it's just so amazing, guys. I really love it. I also do use a sketch kind of like paper-like protector, and it definitely helps to give it a more sketchy feel. But one of the first tips that I want to talk about is having a reference, like a reference page, or just, you know, pictures and things that inspire you. So right here, you see I have, to the left of the screen, I have a picture of this really beautiful girl, and under it I have these cute little eyes that I'm really inspired by. And that's basically just kind of keeping me into that mode to just think, okay, I need to look at this image of this girl and I need to imagine her as if she was a cartoon, or if she was an anime, or in my style. So that's just kind of keeping my mind, you know, focused on the goal. Like, okay, I need to make sure that I'm turning her into, you know, one of my characters. So, you know, having the picture of those cute anime eyes next to my reference, it really just helps to keep my mind in that mindset. And it's just such a great way to, you know, especially if you're in an art block, to get yourself inspired, have pictures right beside you. And this app that I'm using to the left is called Vids, and it does cost around $3 to $4. So if you do not want to pay for it, which is totally fine, all you have to do is you can make your own reference pages using Procreate app. You can use PixArt, you can use Photoshop, you can use any app that basically makes collages, and just get pictures from Pinterest. I love Pinterest, you guys. Like, that's one of the best apps ever. Like, this is my favorite app, literally. I love Pinterest, and I just really get so many inspirational photos and pictures and stuff from there. So just basically get a lot of pictures that you like, put them together, especially if you have like a specific focus for your image. For example, like I decided that I wanted to draw like this Pikachu inspired girl. Really, I wasn't planning it. I was just really wanting to draw like a cute little animal or pet next to her, but Pikachu popped up and I was like, oh my gosh, I'll draw Pikachu with her and kind of like be inspired by Pikachu to, you know, give me the inspiration for the colors and the rest of her outfit and all of that stuff. And you know, her hair was already red too, so it just really kind of worked out. So yeah, you don't have to get this VizRef app. You can just get a whatever collage app that you can find and just have a reference page available for you while you're drawing. I think that's one of like the best things to do. And another little tip is you can watch my video on how I do my reference pages. I'll put that up for you guys so you guys can see that video if you're interested, because it can really just make your art like so much better when you're just, you know, inspired by different pictures and things, and you know, just keeping your mind active on, you know, those inspirations. And I also have a couple of pictures from my favorite artist, Chris Sanders, too. Like, oh my gosh, I love his art. Very, very inspired by his artwork, so I have that there too. So it's pretty random. It's just pictures that I'm inspired by at the moment, because I have a tons of different reference pictures and stuff that I use for other images. But yeah, like, it's super fun. Another tip that I want to give you guys while I'm drawing the cute little Pikachu right here. Oh my gosh, you guys, it took me like forever to kind of get this right, because I'm not used to drawing animals. So like, I was definitely like just trying over and over again. And that's one of the tips that I wanted to give you guys. When it comes to digital art, make sure that you warm up before you start your artwork. And I'm going to give you guys an example right here. Basically, you can draw a ton of shapes, just any kind of shape that you would like, and just basically it's getting you warmed up and it's getting you just into the feel and the vibe of your digital artwork. Especially if you're just starting out, you want to make sure you're comfortable using your digital pen, and you know, just using your Apple Pen or whatever digital tool that you're using, and you just want to make sure you're very comfortable before you start. And another way that I like to warm up is I would draw the image that I'm, you know, drawing from, like the reference image. I'll draw it a couple of times until I'm comfortable with it, and just do it over and over again until I feel like I'm ready to start refining the details. Oh my gosh, you guys, I cannot explain to you how much that helps me so much, you guys. Just drawing over and over again until you get it right. Because I remember when I used to, you know, draw and like something wouldn't turn out the way that I would want, and then I would just give up. And I'm just like, wow, I can't believe I did that. All I have to do is just keep trying and just do it over and over again until I'm warmed up and I feel more comfortable with it. And then I can get into the vibe and feel of it and, you know, just keep going until it starts to turn out good. So I think that's an awesome, awesome tip. So definitely make sure you warm up. That's super important. Another tip that a lot of people, I think, don't really realize is that we have to make sure we flip our image back and forth, like horizontally flip it, like to the different sides so you can see how it looks like mirrored. So for example, this is super important, especially if you're trying to create merch with your artwork. Definitely you want to make sure you're flipping the image back and forth so you can see how it would look as if you would, you know, look into the mirror and look at your artwork. Because I remember when I used to make artwork and I did not flip it, so I couldn't see what it looked like on the other side, because sometimes when you flip it can look a little wonky because, you know, our mind is, you know, thinking like, okay, this looks fine this way, but we're not thinking on the other perspective of things. And this can also improve your drawing skills because it just will help you to start thinking more, you know, to, you know, making sure things and shapes and the lines and everything are just looking more equal to each other. So yeah, definitely make sure you flip your piece back and forth while you're in the sketch stage before you color so you can get everything right. So that's, I think, is a big deal. So definitely try that, and that'll definitely help improve your art skills and your digital art as well. So yeah, those are just a few tips that I have, you guys. I also have my Patreon, you guys, where I teach you all monthly tutorials, full real-time tutorials, where you can see me draw from start to finish, step by step. So if you guys are interested in learning from me, full real-time tutorials monthly, and seeing behind the scenes, seeing artwork that I've never posted anywhere before, definitely check out my Patreon, you guys. Just visit patreon.com/rawsushi and join the Patreon fam. Oh my goodness, you guys, all of my patrons, they love the tutorials, they love everything that I have to offer there. So if you are, you know, willing to check it out, and it's a great way to support me as well, that would be so awesome. But even if you don't, like, I totally understand, and thank you so much for supporting me anyways on my YouTube. Just by watching my videos, you're supporting me, so thank you guys so much for that. So yeah, if you are, you know, wanting to see tutorials from me behind the scenes, receive rewards and benefits monthly, then just go ahead and check out my Patreon at patreon.com/rawsushi, you guys. So yeah, that's another way to learn digital art from me. And another awesome way to learn digital art, you guys, is Skillshare. Like, oh my gosh, y'all, like, Skillshare has been basically one of my favorite places to basically get back to, like, my drawing mode and really improve my skills, you guys. Like, y'all, Skillshare is the bee's knees. So if you don't know what Skillshare is, it's an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. And you can explore new skills, deepen your existing passions, and get lost in your creativity, y'all. Like, oh my gosh. And one of my favorite classes on Skillshare, y'all, is a class by Gabrielle Bricky. It's called Character Illustration, Drawing Female Portraits in Procreate. Like, oh my gosh, y'all, like, this class is so lit. It's so awesome. Like, I love how she explains things. So I would definitely recommend, if you're just getting on Skillshare, to check out Gabrielle Bricky. She's really dope, really awesome, you guys. So check out her class, y'all. But Skillshare is super awesome because, you know, there's no ads on there. They're always launching new premium classes, and it'll just really just keep you focused, man. And it'll take you just wherever your creativity wants to go. So this is really awesome. They have so many other different classes too, and I think it's definitely worth checking out. And y'all, it's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription, so it's really, really lit. I would just so recommend it, y'all. So if you're interested in going to Skillshare and learning, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of a premium membership, y'all, so you can explore your creativity to its fullest. So yeah, y'all, I would definitely recommend it, so check that out if you want to improve your skills some more. So yeah, you guys, I really hope that, you know, my tips that I gave y'all, you know, it was just a little bit of tips just to improve your digital art skills, some that I think that are super important, making sure you have a reference, making sure that you flip your picture back and forth, and also just making sure that you warm up, you guys. Warming up is super, super important, and just making sure you get into that flow and get yourself comfortable with your digital artwork. So I definitely recommend it, y'all. And also check out my Patreon, y'all. We doing monthly full real-time tutorials on there. Y'all can see how I draw my cute raw babes, how I draw my characters, and also get to see artwork that I've never shown anywhere else, you guys. And also you get discounts on my shop, y'all, and you can get a monthly coloring page and wallpaper for your phone and just a lot of other cool benefits. So yeah, you guys, if y'all interested, just go ahead and check the links below so y'all can check out my Patreon, because it's lit, y'all. Oh my gosh, y'all. But yeah, that app has been such a huge blessing to me. Patreon has been just so amazing, and it's really just helping me to spend more time on my artwork and create more awesome content for you guys. So thank you all to all who have joined my Patreon already. Y'all are awesome. Y'all are lit. I love y'all so much. Also, you guys, I will be uploading the Procreate files of this drawing on my Patreon. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and check out that description. And also, just thank you guys so much for being subscribed, watching my videos, regardless if you join my Patreon or not. Y'all are so awesome. Thank you so much for viewing. Thank you for being so positive and sweet in the comments. I hope that these tips were able to help you guys some. I hope that, you know, you guys still enjoy watching my videos and supporting me with whatever, you know, new journey or thing that I want to try, you guys. I just really appreciate your support, and whatever I decide to do, like, that really means a lot. And I thank God so much for awesome people like you all. So thank you so, so, so much. Like, you guys are so awesome, and I really hope that you all enjoyed watching this video, my little peekaboo. I think she came out cute. Oh my gosh, I really love it. And as you can tell, I also did a little something different with the eyes. Now I love adding all the little sparkles and all the cuteness. I just love that so much. So yeah, you guys, if you're interested in seeing more behind the scenes and stuff from me, just check out the description below to join my Patreon and check out Skillshare and practice those tips that I told y'all, you know, practice those tips, warm up, references, flip that picture back and forth. And yeah, you guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Love you guys so much. Peace, love, and God bless, my loves. Bye.